fresco is the...
Who's al fresco?
No, al fresco. It means outside in Italian.
Oh. You know I'm not Italian, don't you?
No, it's just another way of saying eating outside.
But it's not a way of saying it that I understand.
Well, next time someone says it, you will understand it, won't you?
Oh, yes. I suppose I will. I am eating my breakfast, Bob Rescue.
No, al fresco. Co. Al fresco.
Bless you.
Why do you hug your orange juice before you drink it?
Because you said orange juice tasted better when it's freshly squeezed.
No, it's the oranges never mind. Shall I make some more?
Yes, please. Is it me, or is that seagull staring at my breakfast brioche? I don't trust seagulls. Remember that time we were having fish and chips at the seaside, and a seagull stole my chips, and my pickled egg, and my fish, and the paper it was wrapped in, and my bike?
Why would a seagull want your bike?
It had 5 gears and a Thomas the Tank Engine bell. It's quite a catch for a seagull. Ah! Help! Seagull attack! That seagull's got my breakfast! Call the Air Force! Get me a jetpack!
I shouldn't have filled this up so high. I hope nothing gives me a big shock, because it'll go everywhere. Little Howard? Little Howard?
Hi, Little Howard! I've come up with another of my big questions! Why can't I fly?
All I'd ask is it gave me a little bit more warning when you were going to do that.
It's going to be a beautiful day today, especially if you live in Purley, where we're getting reports of monkeys dancing in the streets.
I love monkeys, I love monkeys. All those happy little chirpy little monkeys with their tails and their bananas. I think that if we all were monkeys, we'd have happier mananas. Give me monkeys, lots of monkeys. Boy, you know that it's the monkeys I adore. If my love said that she did not love those monkeys, I wouldn't love her anymore. Thank you very much!
We love you too, Little Howard.
We're gonna have to take that again, one of the monkeys talks.
Ah, oh, for goodness sake. Sorry, it's just that you sing this song about how much you love monkeys every week, and I just thought on
the
half of the
lads... Yeah, but we're still filming! You can't just talk while we're still rolling! This is the titles for the show, for goodness sake!
Sorry, Little Howard.
Well, it's too late now. It's gonna have to come out of your wages.
We're ready for another take.
Stupid monkeys.
You can't fly because of gravity.
What's gravity? Is it a cross between gravy and tea?
No.
Oh, yeah, sorry, that's Bovril, isn't it? Is gravity like Bovril?
No.
Is gravity like any of the other beef-based beverages that are available on the market?
No. Gravity is the force that pulls us down towards the ground. It's the force that made the orange juice fall on my head.
So it's like clumsiness.
That was not clumsiness. You made me jump.
How would Oliver drink water read? Look at the state of you. Get in the bath this instant.
That is where I was going. Little Howard, I need to have a word with Mother. Could you go up and fill the bath for me, please?
Okay.
Listen, Little Howard's got it into his head that he wants to learn to fly. Can you please tell him it's not possible? He won't listen to me.
Of course. And don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
I filled the bath, Big Howard.
Brilliant. Remember what I said, Mother?
Mother's the word.
That's what I said.
Now, what's all this nonsense about you wanting to fly?
It's not nonsense. I do want to fly.
Humans aren't built for flight. Their bones are too big and heavy. Birds can fly because their bones are so light they're almost hollow. If human bones were that flimsy, you'd collapse in a heap. Especially if for a great fat thing like Big Howard. Also, birds have 2 sets of very strong breast muscles that account for 35% of their body weight. If humans had them, they'd look like this. And no one looks like that. But if they did, they'd never fall down a manhole again, would they?
So those are the only reasons that humans can't fly, then?
Well, there's that. But of course, they don't have wings.
Oh. Right. But I see people flying all the time on telly.
I know. I'll show you some people who look like they're flying, and you've got to tell me how they're doing it.
Wow, he's not touching the ground! He's flying!
Sadly not. Look. You see, he wasn't really flying. He'd just been shot out of a cannon. How about this one?
He's floating in mid-air.
How do you think he's doing it, though?
I'd say His lovely bouffant hair was made of magic.
Good guess, but they're not flying, they're actually falling. But the plane they're in is falling at the same speed, so it looks like they're floating. It's called parabolic flying.
So it's not his hair that's magic, then.
Little Howard, when I said to fill the bath, I meant to fill it with water.
Oh.
And whatever horse you got that from needs to see a vet.
Now, do you see that ordinary people can't fly?
Yes, I suppose so.
Good. So let's hear no more of this nonsense. Mind you, superheroes can fly, of course.
Are superheroes real?
Oh, yes. Big Howard used to be a superhero, you know?
No. I'd know if he was.
Well, he could never give away his secret identity. But look!
Help! Help! Big Hero! Help!
Just, damsel, fear not. Big Hero's here.
Big Hero, thank goodness.
Big Pooh!
What did he say?
Big Hero?
Sounded quite a lot like Big Pooh.
No, definitely Big Hero.
Right, what can I do for you, hot stuff? Can I save your baby from a tidal wave? Can I wrestle a bear? Can I punch a giant iguana?
No, I've forgotten where I parked my car.
Find your flipping car. I can fly at 10,000 miles an hour, for heaven's sake.
It's a yellow Fiat Punto.
Fine.
Big Howard can fly!
Yes, but he hasn't done it for years.
Has he still got his magic costume?
Oh, I wouldn't let him throw that out. Here, that gives me a very irresponsible idea.
What are you doing?
I'm throwing all your clothes up on the roof.
Oh, I see. Okay. Sure. See you.
What? Why?
So you can fly up and get them.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yep, got you. On.
What? Wait, why? I told Mother to tell you that people can't fly, and now you seem to think that I can fly, and you've thrown all my clothes on the roof. What on earth did she say?
It's okay, Big Howard. I know all about your secret identity. And besides, I haven't thrown all your clothes up on the roof.
Oh, no.
But I saw you flying with my own eyes.
I was acting, Little Howard, in a TV show called The Extraordinary Adventures of Big Hero. It was a job I did before I started doing comedy. I never actually flew. It was all done with special effects.
But how did you fly in the mystifying mystery of the missing yellow Fiat Punto?
I'll explain once we've got my clothes off the roof.
Well, you're going to have to fly to do that, because remember, the ladder got stolen by those squirrels.
Oh, yeah. I'll call the fire brigade. They'll get my clothes down. Hello, the fire brigade. Could you come round and take my trousers down, please? Yes, all right. Goodbye. They said never to call again, especially in the event of a fire.
So can you show me how you flew, then?
I'll do just that. To the BBC.
Oh, is there a dress code?
Oh, good heavens, no.
Brilliant! Amazing! It's magic!
I'm afraid it isn't.
Who are you?
This is Charlie, my old director. We worked together on my TV show.
What idiot gave you your own TV show?
Oh.
Yes, well, that nearly got me fired. Anyway, it only looks like you're flying on the TV. A computer removes all the blue and puts in a picture of, well, whatever you like. Take a look at this.
Oh, look! Look, I'm flying! On the telly, I'm flying! But I'm not even moving. That's rubbish. But wow, look, I'm moving! I'm really moving! No, I'm not. All I can see is a load of blue everywhere. This must be what it's like to live at the bottom of the sea.
Yeah, imagine that. And before they invented computers, they used to do it with rear projection. Just step over here, please.
What's this?
This is the Wright brothers, who were one of the first people to successfully build and fly an aeroplane in 1903.
Oh, it was going to hit us.
It's not real, Big Howard. Ow! I'm afraid I'm not interested in flying in an aeroplane, Charlie.
And why not?
I don't like the food.
Well, if you want to fly without an aeroplane and without wings, I might know someone that can help. Some scientists at the University of Nottingham have managed to make tomatoes and strawberries levitate using magnets.
Wow, that's amazing! Can you take us there right now? With TV magic?
Of course not. I'm a TV director, not a wizard. Just step over here.
Because you can't do it, isn't it? Rubbish. Yeah. Oh, come on!
OK, and jump in the air, please.
Thanks, Charlie!
The University of Nottingham's Tomato and Strawberry Levitating Department!
Something like that, yeah. Come on.
Don't look now. We're being followed. Look!
You said I shouldn't look now.
That was then. You can look now. It's that seagull.
I can't see him.
On that lamppost, taunting us with his twitchy beak. The one who stole my breakfast brioche. Look at him, that dirty brute.
How can you be sure it's the same seagull?
I'd know him anywhere. Those greedy eyes, the brioche crumbs stuck to his claws. I'm going to learn to fly and I'm going to get you!
Richard from the Diamagnetic Levitation Department's waiting for us. Come on.
Shall we run?
Yeah.
Dinner, 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 lunch!
We've heard that you can make things levitate.
Yeah, that's true. We can make things fly. Make things levitate using this machine. The moment it's set up for levitating things with lots of water in, so fruit and vegetables, that kind of thing.
Fantastic. Can you levitate a raspberry?
Yeah, we can levitate a raspberry.
What about an elderberry?
Yeah, we can levitate that too.
What about a loganberry?
Yeah.
A kumquat?
Yeah, kumquat as well.
I'm not sure I even know what a kumquat is.
What about a gooseberry?
Little Howell, can you stop just listing fruit? Richard, can you show us some of the stuff that you can make levitate?
Inside this tin can, we have a very strong electromagnet. Now, an electromagnet is a coil of wire wrapped round and round which you pass an electric current through. When we pass so much electric current, it generates a very powerful magnetic field. And this magnetizes objects that you don't normally think of as magnetic, fruits and vegetables and so on.
Anti-gravity blackberry. Wow. It's flying! Mushrooms can fly! Make it spin, Richard. Make it spin round. Go and ask him, please.
Yes, all right, calm down. Little Howard would like to see if this can fly. It's called Super Sausage.
Come on, Super Sausage, come on. All the mustard you want if you can do this, come on. Oh, you're rubbish, Super Sausage. Excuse me, Mr. Scientist. Why can't you make Super Sausage fly?
The magnet is set up for levitating water at the moment, and the Super Sausage just doesn't have enough water in. He's just a bit too fatty.
Big Hero, we could always try Plan B.
Yes, all right. Can you try this as well? He's called Mega Carrot.
Yeah, okay.
Is it an orange bird? Is it an orange plane? No, it's a levitating root vegetable. It's Mega Carrot! He's flying! Come on!
suppose you could...
Big Howard, you just ate super sausage!
Could you ever make people fly with this?
Well, we could, but we just can't fit people inside the small hole. So yep. I'm sorry, little Howard, you're just too big to fit.
Well, we appear to be experiencing slight technical problems with Little Howard's dream sequence. Normal service will be resumed in a few moments. So, in the meantime, here are some silly messages from our sponsors.
Fed up of sitting in traffic? Bored of long delays on the roads, trains and airlines? Then you need a Woolux Easylift flying carpet. Avoid commuter drudgery in style, with a range of attractive patterns and textures, from the Velvertical Maxi Shag Boost to the one-man short-haul bath mat. And remember, Woolux Easylift flying carpets are not available in shops or anywhere else. But if you register your bank details on our website, we'll let you know as soon as we work out how to make one.
Coming soon, Big Buzzer, the reality show in which 150,000 bees move into the Big Buzzer hive and are voted out one at a time, week by week, until only one is left. Unless the Queen is voted out, in which case they all swarm. Big Buzzer, starting Friday and continuing for the next 55 weeks, which isn't as long as Big Brother lasts.
Little Howard? Little Howard?
Brilliant! So we can use this machine to make us fly.
Haven't you been listening to it? Richard's just explained that we can't make people fly with it.
Could we trade some superhero carrots to do it for
Little
us?
Little Howard! Sorry, he goes into these dream sequences. Little Howard, you having a dream sequence again?
Yeah.
Well, stop it.
It was a really good one this week.
Oi!
Oh, sorry. So I'm no closer to learning to fly, then?
Well, I did tell you about Jetman.
Jet who?
Oh, for goodness sake, Richard told us about a man in Switzerland who could fly using jet power.
Hooray! Where's Switzerland?
I don't know, but he also said there's a bloke in the UK who's trying to do it as well.
Oh, is that the bloke who flew over the English Channel?
Yeah, it took a lot of hard work, that. It's basically a standard aerodynamic, rigid, aeroplane-type carbon fibre wings with a span of about 8 feet. Then you've got four small kerosene-burning jet engines underneath that are a bigger version of a type designed for model aeroplanes. You use the hand throttle and your body to manoeuvre, and Bob's your uncle.
Wow! It must be amazing being able to fly.
Yes, yes, I suppose it must be, mustn't it? Yeah.
Don't you know?
Oh, well, I've never actually gone as high as that with my own jet wings.
You mean that's not you?
Oh, no. No. No, but not yet. But it will be when I get the funding.
Who's that, then?
Well, that's Yves Rossi. He's an ex-military pilot from Switzerland. He's a nice bloke, a bit of a swat, though. And of course, he's got a girl's name. But me and him have been working to perfect jet-propelled human flight for 20 years or more. Of course, he's rather got the edge on me now.
So how high can you fly at the moment, then?
Well, I'll show you if you like. Yeah, if you two pop out of the shed, then I'll get jetted up, as we jet men call it.
Brilliant!
Brilliant! He'll never be able to fly very high, will he?
Well, I don't know. It depends how powerful his jet engines are. He seems to know what he's talking about.
He lives in a shed.
Well, he's been working very hard on this for a long time.
I don't know if you've noticed, but I actually had to use some ordinary household objects. Don't worry, though, the principle is as sound as a pound.
Really? As much as a pound?
Can you fly as high as a seagull?
Well, it depends how high the seagull is.
What about getting my clothes off the roof?
I could lend you a ladder.
That would be great, actually, if you could.
No! We need you to fly!
OK, well, let's fire this baby up and see how high she goes.
Woo!
I've made some minor adjustments this morning, so fingers crossed, it should go higher than Tuesday. Obviously, today, though, the wind is...
Get on with it!
Right, yes. OK, well, should I have a countdown?
Yeah.
Yeah. 100.
10.
90. 10. Oh.
9. 8. 7.
Watch it.
6. Five. 4, 3, 2, 1! Hooray! Ah, monkey nose.
Well, it was better than Tuesday.
So, about that ladder then?
Oh, it looks like I'm never going to be able to fly.
Oh, don't be like that. I know somewhere you can fly.
What do you mean?
Have you never heard of indoor skydiving?
No.
Oh, they do it in Bedford.
Hooray! Bedford!
Yeah, I can take you there now if you like.
Brilliant!
If you pay me bus fare.
Yeah, all right, I suppose.
And lend us 40 quid.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Well, where is it? It's brought us to the middle of nowhere. There's nothing here, just a load of... All right.
Yeah, there it is. It's the largest indoor skydiving wind tunnel in the world, you know. And they do a very good bacon sandwich as well. Yes, it's safer and a lot less scary than actual skydiving, you know, which is just as well, because I'm not terribly keen on heights, so...
What?
Wow, look at them, they're brilliant at it.
Hey guys, welcome to Bodyfly. We are the world's largest and fastest indoor skydiving facility.
Wow, look at them, look how high they're going. They're spinning round and round and round and round and round and round and round.
Right, your legs, he's gonna bend them slightly, right the knee. We need to keep you in a stable flying position. Okay, not too bad, not too bad. Good, good, good. And bring your palms up. Well done. Okay, guys, there we go. Look at that perfect body position.
SWAT, teacher's pet.
Okay, so that's the propeller. It's got a diameter of 5 meters. That's twice the size of you. And it goes 150 miles an hour and 750 revs per minute. It doesn't blow you up, sucks you up. The air goes round the sides, comes back, circulates, pushes you back up again.
Yeah, let's fly at last!
Ready to go, let's go.
Woo! All right now, there's a very good cafe downstairs, you know. Oh dear.
Happy face!
Turn it off! Come on!
Maybe Jet Man shouldn't have had all those bacon sandwiches.
Apparently he's sick every time. Every time he's been, they have to clean the fan.
He's very impressive, isn't he?
He's almost as good as the experts, isn't he? The way he's flying up there, Jet Man. No, he's rubbish, isn't he? He's terrible.
I thought he said he'd done it before.
Apparently he has. He's done it about 80 times. It's just never really got any better.
I'm flying! I'm flying! Look at me! Woohoo! I'm flying! Someone's doing a lot of rotor stroking! Wow! That was amazing! We were flying!
Yeah, and Jetman UK lent us his ladder.
For a small fee.
For a very reasonable fee, which means we don't have to fly to get the clothes off the roof.
Could you be careful with that, Big Howard?
Of course I'll be careful with that. Oh, sorry, did I... Oh, my goodness, I'm so sorry. You OK?
Right. Oh, if I had a nose, that would have been broken. Now I've flown properly, I think I can forgive the seagull folks. Hey, look at you, Big Howard! A seagull did a poo on you! That's revolting. Stop, buddy, stop it.
That seagull's just eating my hot dog. Here, hold these, will you?
Go get him, hot dog man. Hot dog man could be like a partner to Super Sausage, couldn't he? They could fight Mustard Mouse, and it would be a really good team. Little Howard?
I'm up here, Big Howard. I'm flying!
Let go of the balloons, Little Howard.
I'm flying a bit too high, actually.
Second thoughts, don't let go of the balloons, Little Howard. Hold on!
Ah, help me! I'm flying!
Up there, look at him float off without a care. Drifting like a bin bag in the air. He could pretty much go anywhere. Up there, fly. All I wanted to do was to fly. Now it seems that I'm about to die. Falling like a rock down from the sky. Oh, why? 'Cause falling is natural. Flying it is not. Oh, gravity has news for me that cannot be forgot. Aeroplane or helicopter, when I land I'll need a doctor. Jetpack me direct to A&E. Growing wings could be a curse unless they flew me to a nurse. An NHS one, please, 'cause they are free. Hovercraft or lead balloon, please take me to a doctor soon. Fly me with a magnet to a quack. Then when I have convalesced, I'll tell you what would be the best. Please don't even try to fly me back. Flying is easy. It's landing, that's the worst. I hope I'm near a hospital when the bubbles burst.
Down! They saved me! The seagulls saved me!
Falling is natural, flying it is not. Oh, gravity has news for me that cannot be forgot.
The seagulls saved my life!
Yeah, you see, they're not that bad, are they? Thank you, seagulls!
Look at your face! I've changed my mind. Seagulls are brilliant.
Yeah, they're great. I'm going to join the RSPB.
That cannot be forgot.
Hello, everyone. I'm sorry, I don't actually know where Big Howard is. He was here a minute ago.
Little Howard, look, I'm flying!
How are you doing that?
I'm on wires like they use in the theatre.
Isn't that very expensive and you need an expert to come in and set it all up for you?
Yeah, but I just made this myself with an old belt and some fishing wire. It's just as strong.
Stop filming! Call an ambulance!
Are you ready to take the Mega Nanny Challenge?
Would you like CBBC's Mega Nanny to come to your home for a weekend your whole family will never forget?
She's not your normal sort of nanny. It'll be 2 days full of action-packed mayhem. Plus, there may even be some prizes.
If you think you, your brothers, sisters, or any other children in your home aged between 5 and 12 have got what it takes, then check out the website.
Just click on Be On A Show for more details and an application form. Closing date is the 6th of February. Good luck.
This is your CBBC tag team. These are your teammates. Tracy. Basil. Raven. Sean. And Oucho. Join forces with your CBBC favourites. Play cool games. Unlock top secret rewards. Then send to your mates to see if they can top your score. Go to the CBBC website and click on games. Let your tag team begin.